the southeast of Ireland, 14 kilometers north of medieval Kilkenny City, in the ancient East, surrounded by centuries of history, castles, and churches, in the lush, rolling hills and valleys, and old home of the Bishop of Ossory and the Mill Hill missionaries. Lies a unique heritage village. Welcome to Freshford, a picturesque village located in the heart of County Kilkenny. Today we invite you to embark on a journey with us as we explore the hidden treasures and rich history that make Freshford a truly unique destination. Freshford's history dates back centuries, evident in its well-preserved architecture and quaint streets. The village square is a hub of activity, surrounded by charming cottages and traditional pubs. Each building tells a story of the village's past, offering visitors a glimpse into its fascinating heritage.
Welcome to St. Lectin's Church, Museum and Art Centre, Freshford. Freshford, or Oca Uair, stretches back to a time around the beginning of the 5th century when the Corcaleadh clan from Muskerry and West Cork set forth in search of new lands and settled here, where they cleared the Oca Uair, or Fresh Field, on the banks of the Nuenna River. The anglicised version, Freshford, stems from a later mistranslation of the Irish word Oca as ford, rather than its correct meaning, field, and Uair meaning fresh. Approximately 150 years later, St. Lectin arrived and set up the monastic foundation. This has been a holy place since that time, with more than 1,400 years of continuous worship.
When St. Lectin arrived here, this place would have been nothing like this. No roads, no stone buildings initially. He would have probably come to a cleared area beside the river. It would have developed into an enclosure. There would have been some huts, a timber church to start with, a little wooden church, and there would have been an enclosure with the river up here, and there is a ditch that still survives, an enclosing foss or ditch down near the National School. And he may have come with a few companions, or they may have joined this holy man. Word may have gone out about him. But a monastery, an early Christian monastery, grew up in this place.
Freshford has a long history of community spirit and engagement. Over the years, the village has had numerous events and festivals, from an annual pantomime with a cast from the village to historical pageants reenacted on the village square. The village was also host of the Irish Conquer Championships, held in autumn for a number of years. Last year, to commemorate the 1400th anniversary of St. Lactin's death in 622, Freshford hosted its latest festival, a year-long program of events and activities to celebrate the saint, Féile Lactin. Events were held throughout the year, including St. Lactin's feast day, a church service, celebrating our shared Christian heritage, opened in St. Lactin's Church of Ireland. The community participated in a procession up to St. Lactin's Roman Catholic Church, where the ceremony was concluded. A reception was held afterwards in the community hall. Fela Lactin is happening again this year, with events well underway. In April, the festival was officially launched with a lecture on a history of the GAA in 100 objects. The museum was relaunched with a talk on the history of local bands, part of the village's deep connection with music. A concert was held with the Super Noodles, one of the village's longest-running bands. A second concert was held in May with up-and-coming musician Kira Dalton. In September, Will Killeen plays, and Don Baker closes the festival in October. On June 17th, the village prepared to receive a very special visitor. Lav Lactin, a truly unique artifact from Irish history, made its way to the village. Housed in the National Museum, alongside the Ardor Chalice, St. Lactin's hand is a truly priceless work of art. 14 centuries after the death of the patron saint of the village, the people of Freshford witnessed this magical piece in their own home. A truly special and unique event, and a proud moment for all. As with most vibrant and energetic communities, the life force of this area is the clubs and societies and interest groups. We have a myriad of such groups and societies here in Freshford. There are the sporting and outdoor recreational groups, St. Lactin's GAA and Camogie clubs, the backbone of communities countrywide. The GAA club in Freshford have embarked on a new development plan this year, which included the construction of a brand new walking track with LED lighting, Freshford Town Soccer Club, Freshford Boxing Club, the newly established Nuenna Athletics Club with juvenile and adult sections, the Squash Club, which has squash courts and a fully kitted out gym. The Squash Club building is the next on the list to retrofit and upgrade its energy provision. An energy audit has been carried out there by the SEAI, and the recommendations will form the basis of its development plans. For other types of outdoor recreation, there is a rambling group which utilizes the Freshford Loop Walk, a group of mountain bike enthusiasts, which is the nucleus of a new subcommittee investigating the possibility of building mountain bike trails and a pump track in some nearby woods, and a wild swimmers group who meet and swim all year round in the swimming area of the local Millennium Park. Culture and heritage, built and natural, are woven throughout the activities of many of the other groups in our locality. The UNAD Lactin Committee, which runs Fela Lactin with its program of art, culture and heritage. The Freshford Heritage Group, which maintains the local park. The Acorn Club, which put on concerts, but during COVID, pivoted to become a philanthropic group responsible for providing funding for 3 defibrillators in the village. A sound and lighting system in the UNAD Lactin venue, and a sensory garden in the local primary school. The Tidy Towns Group, which maintains the village and keeps biodiversity and climate action to the forefront in all their activities. And the Playground Groups, who worked extremely hard to get the beautiful playground we have today. We have 2 book clubs in the village, one for the daytime and one for the nighttime. And the new community cafe has an activity space where art classes, flower arranging, knit and natter sessions, active retirement group meetings, and quilting classes take place. And even though this is not an exhaustive list, a lot is going on in this little village.
Welcome to the Loop Cafe. My name is Katie. On my right is Paula, Grace, and Julie. We are 4 of the Loop Community Cafe volunteers. We've just taken 4 years to get this place open. So welcome to everybody. This is our first day and we're all so excited. So cheers!
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 Yes. Premises did not look like this when we started here. It was a fairly run down, derelict chipper which had been closed for many years. We took it on and we had to get members of the community to do all the work for us. So all of the labour,
materials
were begged, borrowed, appropriated,
donated
all the time from the tradesmen was donated, and it's taken us 9 months to get this far, to get this building from what it was to what it is now. We're so grateful to the credit union and this community fund. We've been awarded €5,000, which will go towards kitting out and equipping our community cafe and our activity space, which we also have in this cafe.
The doors are open, we're welcoming people in, we can't wait to share the happy community space that we have created.
Cheers. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
In the last number of years, we have tried to bake in sustainability to our project process using the UN Sustainable Development Goals, particularly goals 11, 12, 15 and 17 as a guide. The Community Cafe project is an example of repurposing, upcycling and reusing. We renovated an old, derelict chip shop into a bright and vibrant cafe, reusing and repurposing as much material as we could. The new lighting in the Millennium Park is solar-powered and ecologically friendly, and the new street nameplates were made from vernacular limestone by a local stonemason. We have started a better energy program through SEAI and have installed a heat pump in St. Lactin's Church, and are currently examining the recommendations in the energy audit completed on the Squash Club. The Tidy Towns group have really taken the lead in this area, with numerous biodiversity and sustainability projects. A Freshford area biodiversity plan was commissioned, and the recommendations are being followed. The blueprint is to make the village a biodiversity corridor with the river as the main conduit. An all-village planting plan was devised by our resident horticulturist, and it includes actions for all the public, municipal, and shared spaces around the village. We have constructed 8 new pollinator beds around the village, planted 10 mini orchards in public spaces, established sapling nurseries for native trees, and carry out seed-saving workshops each year in collaboration with the Acorn Project, Kilkenny's Forest School. We have also built a community composting site with the help of Kilkenny County Council, with a wormery for cafe food waste, leaf mulch cages, and organic matter composting bins for waste from Tidy Town's cleanup activities. We hope you've enjoyed our presentation. Before we invite you on a tour of our very special home, we want to take a moment to remember two of our community's most passionate members who sadly passed away this year. Two men who were true driving forces behind much of our village's activities, landscape, and community. Ned Kennedy and Michael Cass, we will dearly miss you and will always remember your contribution to the place we call home. Thank you.